So, with me, Wayne Goodwin, chair of the North Carolina Democratic Party. Wayne, thank you so much for being here. And, you know, just out of the gate, do you believe that there is evidence that there are enough suspicious ballots in question that could actually change the outcome of this election?
The short answer is yes. We knew there was sufficient evidence even before the hearing began, but with what the investigators have unveiled and what we've been hearing in shocking testimony yesterday and today, and perhaps even going through tomorrow, I believe it just further underscores that there must be a new election. This election was tainted in the 9th Congressional District.
But is it enough to close that 1,000-vote gap?
Well, I believe it is. But in North Carolina, the law says that it's not just showing that there's enough to close the gap. If there was sufficient activity of illegal behavior, and here it's not just a question of alleged election fraud, there's actual election fraud that has been found and admitted to by a witness yesterday and by others. If the election has been tainted in such a way to where there was an unfair process, an unfair election was held, then it doesn't matter if the gap was closed or not. But I believe that the evidence will show that there are sufficient number of requested absentee ballots by mail that never made it back to where they should have gone. We don't know what happened to them, and there's sufficient number of those to eradicate the gap completely. But under the law in North Carolina, you don't have to eradicate the gap if you show that the process was unfair from the get-go.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is what you say. On the flip side, the Republicans, the executive director of the state's Republican Party, says the number of tainted votes he says would not have overcome that vote margin. And this was his response when he was asked, why not have another election?
The level of irregularities have to rise to a level to at least conceivably bring the outcome into question. And, ma'am, we are simply not there.
What would you say to Dallas Woodhouse?
I'd say he's left out a lot of information. The law does not provide for what he said. And second, there is the statement that he and the state Republican Party has said that if it was proven that there was election fraud, and now there's admitted fraud by at least one witness on the stand, and in addition to what was found out today, that there were early vote totals released illegally before the election was over, the Republican Party of North Carolina said that they would call for a new election. Where do they stand on this? They have been on so many sides of this issue. First, they were for a new election, then they were against a new election. They were for certification, they were against certification. And they have been everywhere on this, and the Republican Party and those who are watching this, I believe if you look at the evidence in an objective way, you can only say there must be a new election because this process was tainted, and the evidence supports that.
What about the North Carolina board members? I know there are 3 Democrats and 2 Republicans. Do you have any indication on what they'll decide?
No, of course not. They are free to make up their minds however they choose based on the evidence that they weigh and based on what the law as it is here in North Carolina. And that's what I and the North Carolina Democratic Party has always stood for, is that let the investigators do their job, let the Board of Elections and its members do its job, weigh the evidence, look at the law and see what the law requires based on that evidence and make a ruling. Based on what we know already, for most people, I would think, if not everybody, unless it's someone who is hyper-partisan, you can only rule for a new election. There's just too much illegal activity that's been admitted to and found to rule otherwise.
We will wait to see what they find. We're all watching the 9th very, very closely, as I know you are. Mr. Goodwin, thank you very much for your time there in Raleigh. When we come back... You.